Saxon lord goes amongst his men and says, this is your land, as it was your father's, and your father's before you, and your father's before that. And out of the long years of time that separate us from those who came here first, we are the owners of this land. Will you let these Frenchmen take it from you? Will you? The champions fight, the grass slippery and treacherous beneath their feet. Each one looking to beat the other into submission, to crash him to the floor with a lucky shot, but not to kill. First down, last up is the winner. And so they are recovered by their men. Back to the line he goes with a broken rib here and a cracked collarbone there. Now the battlefield smell of well-sweated leather, the sweat running down into your eyes, trickling from the band of your helmet. It is terrible. The smell of blood and split guts, the sound and sight of your friend, who you've known since boyhood, falling beside you. The sun is hot indeed on your skin.
The guy who runs it, the mill.
That'd be wild.
They look very good. They must be better at riding by now.
See the one with the yellow socks on.
Along your man. Change shoes. 2009.
You got a helmet on, that helmet you never know.
And they had 11 rounds. We had 6.
And at the end.
4 charges. In the end, we were all still up and they were down to about 3.
And the Saxon Lord of Men goes to his men. Remember when we sat together in the hall and I gave you horses and rings and you drank from my cup? And then you said that you would fight for me. You said you would fight for me. And now is the time. Let us push these Normans back to the sea.
It's amazing.
For if we can get rid of them, if we can push them back, if we can send them back to their ships with their tail between their legs, then we may regain this land for ourselves and for our sons and for their children. The Normans on the defensive. The Saxons pushing forward. Pinning down the last few, sending them to meet their maker. But what will happen then? Will the king absorb this? Or will he fight again?
We had the show.
It is. He's gonna win.
But what of the slave? What of the man who threw his daughter in the air laughing this morning? Walked up the lane, giggling and laughing to himself. What of him? What of his wife who leaned on the gatepost this morning and watched him go? Off to fight, he said, back later. What of him? Why he lies upon the grass which he hoped to defend, and soon will lie beneath it. History does not record his name. We shall never know who he was that defended our right to live in this island as we would, that defended his lord's right, William, of conquest, that they should live in this land and rule us. History does not record the names of the men who died for the land they believed in. All it tells us is the names of the great and the good, the powerful and the landed. And the people who did the dying lie beneath the green soil. Not for him the kiss of his wife this evening, but the kiss of the worm in the ground only touch his lips again. And none shall know who he was. But we are fortunate, for we can call upon the dead to rise from the grass. We can face you across the years. For what would you have done? Think now, what would you have done? Would you have taken your father's spear off the wall, put a new rim on your shield, and whistling gone off to fight that morning? Gone to fight, he said, back later. Could you do that? What would you have done if the scales of the many-colored serpent of the shield wall faced you across the green grass of England? What would you have done? Would you have taken up arms against these fearsome foes? Would you have found a spear or a sword? And when the crash of weapon on shield began, and the stepping of the crowd towards you came as a shout of Stepa, 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 Honorise!